working with Habitat this month, and this is the box for those of you that may not see me yet. I'll pass it around so you can see what's inside. But basically, it's just a really amazing experience for us to work together because Habitat are launching Beauty Storage, which is here. So like, come and have a look. And it's just very nice way to store beauty products. It's more of like an objet d'art as opposed to something that's very practical and just has a practical function. It also looks beautiful too. So to celebrate that, we've done this lovely box. And so I'll just pass it around and you can all have a look. And I'll just tell you a bit about BirchBox for those of you who don't know us already. So we're a box company, but we're so much more than that. So our business model is called Try, Learn, Buy. So the idea is you get these 5 beauty samples sent to your house, you get to try them, you'll hopefully learn about them through the inbox editorial cards, which kind of like fold out and they've got little bits about all the products inside. But then we also have a full editorial platform on the website, which I've been working on very closely with my team. And then the idea is you'll love the products so much inside that you'll then want to buy them full size on our retail site. So we have a fully fledged retail site that sells all of the things that we sample in our boxes, but then all other SKUs. So for example, this month we've got Benefit and we've done a thing called Pick Your Sample. So it's basically where people that sign up to the box, they can actually choose one of the 3 mascaras, which are their iconic mascaras. So they've got their Real and Bad Gal, and then they've got a third one, which is their new one, Roll Lash. So, you know, for example, we sampled them in the box, but then we have about 20, 25 different SKUs on the website, so be sure to check it out. But talking about the 3 mascaras and Pick Your Sample, we did 3 different looks, so one to go with each mascara, and we did it as part of a campaign with Habitat and like these beautiful dressing tables, and we also did it with Benefit, so to specifically speak about the different personalities of each of the mascaras. So I'm gonna do like a little bit of a makeup beauty trend vibe, and then Holly's gonna talk you through the dressing table element, because we're actually very excited that Habitat are bringing back the dressing table. I think the whole boudoir retro thing is really coming back, and they've got these beautiful 3 different styles which each have a different personality that go with our girl. So this look is Peach Perfect, and this is something that we did for the Roller Lash mascara, and it's a bit more feminine, it's a bit cute, it's very pretty, and it was kind of seen on the shows. Like, I do a lot of stuff backstage, and I think trends are actually really good when it comes to beauty, but it's how you make them wearable and how you make them usable that kind of makes the look. So here it's all about peach tones, coral tones, really like feminine, really pretty, and maybe I'll pass a few of the products around. So these are all things that we sell on BirchBox. This is one of our cult classics, it's Stila Convertible Colour. So for those of you that maybe aren't beauty girls, this is like very, very good backstage secret. Yeah. And it's actually amazing to use on eyes, lips and cheeks, but maybe not all at the same time. Kick that feature and go for it. Like, they're called convertible colours because you can convert them for each of your different features, but they're really amazing. And then this is the Roller Lash Mascara. So they've called it like you know, put rollers in your hair, rollers for your lashes. But that's really amazing, so I'll pass that round too. And then please feel free to come and have a look at the other products, but then Holly, I'd love for you to speak a bit about this particular dressing table. And it's my favourite.
Yeah, it's my favourite, but I really, it's my favourite.
No, taking the words out of my mouth,
I think, really.
Gorgeous. Yeah, it's funny. I remember when we first started talking about planning this event, and I was asked to sort of do a bit of a chat. I thought it was quite funny because I don't have exactly what you'd call a high maintenance beauty regime. But I think the thing that would induce me to obviously spend a little bit more time sort of pampering in front of the mirror in the morning would be to have an amazing dressing table. And as soon as the sketches for this started to develop, kind of almost a year ago now, I think we all went, wow, that's just such a classic piece, that's going to be amazing. And I think we're all just so pleased and delighted with the final product as well. This is called Emile, and it's just, I think in my mind, it's such a sort of modern classic. And when we styled it for our Spring Summer 15 photography, we paired it with a lot of our ODM textiles, so that's very dusky pinks, soft blues, yellows, and a beautiful brushed brass desk lamp. And it was a very modern, clean, sort of feminine look, which I think has been beautifully sort of emulated by you guys as well. And this colour,
it's almost as if we've had this on
bars, but it's just, it's perfect, because this is exactly the rug and everything else, it's great.
Yeah.
And what I love the fact you've got your little sort of plinth here for the flowers as well. It's just really beautiful.
I just love how big the mirror is.
Yeah.
It's really maximised.
It is great.
On the feeling.
Despite that, despite the fact that it's a really feminine piece, it's just so timeless to me. I just feel like it could work in so many different interiors. And it's just great, it's got so much storage, obviously, so you can hide your clutter, but there's still enough room for your kind of prettiest, sort of nicest essentials. And I mean, probably a lot of you, especially your interior bloggers, have been, are really aware of this trend the last kind of 2 years now, maybe almost, for this sort of very pared down, very elegant dressing tables, quite leggy, very round mirrors, often on stalks, that kind of look. And I like that, but for me, they just look slightly alien-like to me. And I sort of feel that this is a really nice way to tap into that trend, so sort of like Scandinavian sort of feeling, wood, birch, but it's very elegant, and it's just, you know, it's a really nice way to buy into that, because it's a really timeless piece. And it is, you know, I would call it investment piece. I think it really will be quite a classic of the future, so. And also, I'd forgotten this, because I haven't seen one in a fresh while, but if you just, it's such a small detail, but that's what makes it a great design. You've just got a lovely little sort of finger ledge underneath each hole, and it's just, I don't know, it just makes such a difference. I mean, that's the beauty with something like that. It's all in the detail, so. Yes, my fingers.
All the others, which are even fabulous.
Yeah, okay. also lovely.
Change this, so
that.
Okay. So this is Pantone Pick Me Up. We're kind of going along the whole house vibe. The Pantone colour for 2015, as I'm sure you all know, is Masala. So when we were creating this look with Lisa Potter-Dixon, who's the Benefit artist, she really wanted to go big on that colour, because obviously we're going to be seeing it quite a lot. So this kind of setup, this is our kind of artistic watercolour Pantone. Sorry if you can't see it, but you have to stand up. So it's kind of like one of these pretty watercolour eyes. And actually, the nice thing about this look is that it was done with lipstick. So we put lipstick on the eye instead of eyeshadow or cream shadow. And Lisa was saying that it's a technique that a lot of makeup artists are using now, because whilst cream shadows and powders can move and crumble and crease, like lipstick, once you put it on your eyelids, if it's the right formula, it won't move. So that's what we did there. And then you're kind of seeing it all these other shows for this season. And it's quite nice when you do a smoky eye that's in a different colour. Like, it's just a modern take on a classic, and I actually liked this one the best. So whilst that's my favourite dressing table, And then I'll pass around maybe just a few of these products, which are really lovely. So this is the lipstick that we used on the eyes, but then for a darker look, if you wanted to layer up with something from the Stila palette. It's
really
nice.
You might have to like, go into that lipstick on the eyes a bit.
Yeah?
Well,
just want me to go into it?
Yeah, let's hear more about
it. Okay, so, I'm not a makeup artist, but I will talk through it. Okay, so this is the lipstick that we used on the eye, and what Lisa did is that she basically like did a massive smudge of it on her hand like this, and then she got a makeup brush. There is one here somewhere. She used a flat makeup brush and then just literally dipped it in the lipstick and pressed it onto the eye. And then once she'd done that, she blended it with a soft brush for that kind of blown out, diffused feel. Because even though the colour is quite concentrated, she layered it up. So she applied that onto the eyelid, pressed it in, buffed it, applied more lipstick, pressed it in, buffed it, and you can kind of build up the colour as much as you want it to. But I think for that one we only did about two different layerings. And it's really that simple. Like, there's nothing more to it than that. I can see your face, and I'm like, oh, really? Yes, yes, Jimmy at the back.
I have a question, yes. Well, not a question, but one of the great things we were speaking with Lisa, and she was saying that a great reason to use it on the eyelids because it doesn't crease like it does not crease at all. So it's a really, if you want a colour, it's a great way to go with lipstick.
And when we are at least much different.
Tip.
It was
much excitement.
I know. Who would have thought lipstick would be? The good thing about it was that this was the last look we did of the day, because we filmed demo tutorials, so you can actually see all of the demos of this on our website, birchbox.co.uk. But this was the last look that we did it for the day, and I went home on the tube with it, and I caught a glimpse of myself. I was like, oh my god, I don't normally wear a lot of makeup, and I was like, oh my god, that's really strong. And I got home, and my husband was like, should wear your makeup like that a bit more. Anyway, so that was the Pantone eye makeup, and then I'll let Holly talk you through like this lovely artistic dressing table.
Yeah. It's quite apt that there's a kind of quirky approach, I suppose, there with the sort of makeup, because this is one of our more quirky pieces. It's got a feminine aesthetic again, but it's got these lovely mismatched handles, which you can buy obviously with it, but obviously there's, you know, you can go and you can just create your own look by going and buying vintage or found handles obviously from markets and things, which is really lovely. You can have a bit of fun with it. It's quite a creative piece, and the mirror is actually a separate piece, and it's also part of a bigger range. So if you really like that look, there's an 8-drawer tall boy, I think, and a chest of drawers as well. So it's a really nice range to kind of buy into. And this kind of, again, it came from this feel of a bit wanting to be more of a found product. So it's something you might find in your favourite vintage shop or your favourite flea market.
That kind of thing. Modern.
So, yeah, exactly. It's got the nod to those kind of display legs and things like that.
So, it's got quite deep drawers as well, which is quite nice for vintage products.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, and it's a nice sort of action. Something nice than anything, not really kind of feeling of it. But that's, really, really nice. So. Yeah, it's probably one of my favourites.
What's the name of this one?
That is Fleur.
Fleur. Fleur. Oh. I have a question. Can you change the knobs out, or does it come with that set?
I think it comes with that set, yeah. Right. But then obviously you can change yourself and sort of play around with that. But I think you can, I don't think it comes with them in, I think you can figure out where you want to put them,
okay.
Which is nice.
Okay.
And then for our
Pantone
eye makeup, last but not least, I feel like getting like the favourite table, the favourite makeup. But then we've got the undersmoke. So this again, this was Lisa's concept of like the alternative smoky eye, because I really think of smoky eyes. It's maybe more a bit like this at Tom Ford. It's like the blown out black smoky eye. But then she wanted to basically bring it down underneath the lash line. And you kind of see it, Chanel, Celine. And it's basically just bringing it, contrastingly actually opens your eyes, because if you put the colour underneath and then a really full lash mascara, it makes your eyes look bigger, which didn't make sense to me at the time, mm-hmm. And then she did it and I was like, okay, I see what you're talking about. But she said the key for this sort of look is to do it in a different colour. So if you do it in black, it can be very heavy and it can drag your eyes down. But doing it in a purple or a navy blue or an aubergine or even a green, it works really well. And so this is the look that goes with the Bad Gal mascara. So I think she was going for a bit more of a rock and roll feel. But I think for me, it's a bit more of a minimalist beauty look. Like it's something very simple. You can just take an eyeliner and smudge it under your lash line, and then that's a beauty look. So on that note, I'll let Holly talk about our
cool
dressing
table. Cool. So the last one is a little guy called Limbo, and it's a perfect one obviously for a smaller space, so kind of compact, maybe sort of London living or city living, or students, really great for that, because it comes as a set with a little stool as well, which just fits really nicely underneath. So it's a great sort of space saver, and obviously you've got two really big generous drawers there for all your things. I think it's one of our kind of really good sort of entry level ones as well, which is nice if you kind of begin to buy into that beauty look. And I think it's, you know, probably just a nice thing to end on is that all of them are designed in-house by all our designers at Habitat, and they're all exclusive to us, which is great. So we're pretty proud of all of them. So.
And are these two newer? Is that?
They are all the same season, I believe. Yeah, yeah. Somebody else might have to confirm that for me, because I'm relatively new to the company, but yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, so all new for spring, summer 15. So. Did lots of photo shoots about 6 months ago with all these guys in different ways. So, also, as Jess mentioned, we've accessorised them with a lot of our beauty storage. So we've got some bamboo containers and some lovely colour boxes and things. The layered ones there are really lovely. So come and have a look and sort of pick things up and have a look and see.
Lovely to come and have a play. So these are the newer ones. And that's the colours of these are what we based the design of our box on. So we took cues from Habitat's colour palette and used that to go wild and inside the box, in our editorial and also outside the box. tonight. If anyone's got any questions, like, feel free to grab Polly and I. If it's maybe about a bit more about BirchBox and our business model, or beauty questions, or even habitat, and like, Polly's got these amazing tips because we've been running editorial with Polly throughout this month, and just amazing tips of like how to make your living space look bigger and very
bit of a
useful,
team effort, so
useful, constructive stuff. And she's like a wealth of knowledge, so do grab her if you have any questions.
Cool.
And thank you so much for coming. Enjoy the rest of your dinner.